I got this ring at the thrift store, but I immediately thought of you. Yo, Darius Britt here, and today we are reviewing the short film, The Woman in the Yellow Stockings, directed by Gerzegers Muscala. If I butchered it, don't be mad, Gregris. So it's a German film, a little over 6 minutes long. This would definitely be an example of a very European film. I don't think I've reviewed a European film before yet, so this would be number one. Short synopsis. We got a young couple laying around at home, and then the boyfriend decides to propose to the girlfriend, and then... If you haven't seen it yet, I'll leave a link in the description section so you can go over there, throw some eyeballs at it, come back, and then we can chat it up a little bit. Too late. Let's get into it. The title, The Girl in the Yellow Stockings, well, it's definitely more of a poetic kind of title, kind of mysterious. It doesn't tell you much about what the film could possibly be about, but it sounds interesting. It's kind of memorable. Plot structures. Setup. We're introduced to our couple, a guy and a girl in yellow stockings. Inciting incident. The guy proposes to his girlfriend. She doesn't react in the way that you'd expect. Rising action. Things escalate as he keeps asking her and she keeps denying him. Climax. They get into a fight. It's a little uncomfortable. Resolution. They seem to bury the hatchet, at least for now. What works? Well, first off, the story is very simple. Boyfriend asks girlfriend to marry him. That doesn't really require much setup or much explanation because we all understand what that means. The conflict is very clear. He wants her to say yes to his proposal. She keeps playing mind games with him, but they're literally butting heads the entire short as things continue to escalate. The blocking works. Excellent use of blocking. You could turn the sound all the way down and you can still visually tell what's going on with the story. There's a lot of physicality in the short. It helps to tell the story visually. And it's entertaining to watch, especially when things get tense and they start fighting. I was kind of like, okay. The physicality also keeps things from being a bore to watch. Without all that movement and kinetic energy, the short, we would literally just be watching two talking heads. I also like the dialogue. It's very lifelike in its somewhat randomness. I really enjoy the non-conclusive approach to story here. It's more of a slice of lifestyle storytelling. This is not by accident. It is clearly intended to be this way. Nothing is spelled out for you. You're kind of forced to interpret what you think is going on based off what you see. Very, very open-ended. Hence the whole European style storytelling. Shots! So this is a good example of what a film that consists of nothing but close-ups would look like. We're almost always in the actor's faces. This kind of mimics the occasion as well. You know, the whole we find them in bed together, just the two of them proposing, etc., etc. We're so tight on them that we don't even get a good feel for the layout of the room they're in. The benefit of shooting nothing but close-ups is you can move very quickly. Close-ups are a lot easier to light and shoot, but there is a trade-off. Some people in your audience, like myself, don't mind looking at nothing but close-ups, while others do. Stylistically speaking, watching nothing but close-ups can be very visually claustrophobic, and for some people that just ejects them right out of the story. Something to keep in mind. We see this small little detail of the girl playing with her skirt a few times. Small details like this can say a lot with a little, and it's very engaging to watch. I think it means she wants him to fight for her. She wants to make him earn that yes out of her, because every time he's fighting, skirt goes up a little bit, she's into it, but whenever he's not fighting for it, skirt goes right back down. That combined with that whole Napoleon reference she made makes that little connection there. Again, this is just my interpretation of what it means. It's one of those deals where if you ask five different people what they thought it meant, you'll get five different answers. What doesn't work? Well, some people might not care for the open-ended, non-conclusive aspect of it. Some people might even find that artistically pretentious. Some people just don't dig that. And again, with all the close-ups, it does feel a little visually claustrophobic sometimes, but I personally didn't mind it, but I know that there are quite a few people who probably will. That's not really something that doesn't work about the film. I think that's more of a matter of preference or taste. So who's it for? Again, this is a very European style film, so things aren't spelled out for you. If you're not into that type of thing, then you're probably not gonna dig it. And if you're like looking for a straight up love story or something, you're definitely not gonna dig it either. But if you're looking for something that's a little more challenging in the sense that it's not your typical character drama and it doesn't depict your typical love story, then by all means, click on the link below, go check it out. You'll probably dig it a lot, and you can come back and thank me later and say, yeah, I love that film because It was a little weird, and I liked it. Hate it or love it, leave a comment in the comments section and let me know what you thought. Well, that's all I got for you. If you enjoyed what you saw, please like or subscribe. You can find me on the social medias, Facebook, Instagram, or the Twitter, baby. You can also check out my second YouTube channel, Darius Britt, where I vlog about my adventures on the film festival with my first feature-length film, Unsound, live casting, vlogs, etc., etc. I do believe that that is all that I got for you. Deep it out, suckers. Booyah!